Number one, I'm gonna get it, I'll go from there. I'm okay, it's the fact. Now, if you like me, I ask you a word, but I want to be fixed by your change. So do I want to have the unfortunate problem of breaking the fish out just because I didn't want to buy a better line, or I didn't want to have a better rod, or I didn't want to have a better lure? So guys, I'm not telling you to go out and spend $1,000 on a rod, but I'm telling you to spend as much as you possibly can for a rod. Don't try to skimp on your line and your hooks and everything like that. That's just a good start. Like, number one thing, and starting right now, for the baby, is you gotta have a really good pair of polarized plates. And out here, we really need somewhere to see how big our fish actually is, you know. That 8-pound bass that's about that long, you know, it's right here, kind of tells us there. I don't know how many people caught 8-pound bass out here, but, you know, there's probably, if you put this on it, it's probably a lot less. Alright. I don't talk about fishing between, say, October and day. So, I'm gonna go like that right now. And I asked y'all to do one thing for me. I'm gonna tell you how to get the fish for that right now. But please, for the time, for the back and food, don't just keep it over here. Because, please, I will get them. I'm gonna show y'all what the fish are about to run right now. They call them lipless crankbaits, rattle traps. This happens to be a store. Now, I only fish on the weekends, so that's the time I get. But most people say, oh, I want to fish in the mornings, I want to fish in the afternoons, late, and all that. I want to fish 12 o'clock high to about 2:30, and that's about where I quit. Because I fish a shiny prawn bait. Now, fishing a shiny prawn bait is normally when I fish this when it's extremely sunshine. Now, if it's overcast or something, then you want to go to a different color, to a darker color. Lipless bait right now. When I'm saying lipless bait, this is what this is called. This is called a cordial black spot. This is called a rattle trap. And they've done a little bit better job on the rattle traps and the hot spots lately. But the problem is, if you look at the difference in the size of the hooks, this one right here. Alright, this one right here is your red eye shad. Right here. See the difference in the hooks? These have got three of them. You only got two hooks. They're gone. And the other thing is, I feel like, can y'all get the rattle on this one? The rattle right there. That's a different rattle. Now listen to this one. They all got a different rattle. Now, I do have a couple of these things that I've been bringing with me that has no rattle in it. But I feel like right now with the rattle heads. But this is all I'm really throwing right now. And I call 84 pounds. Or Lake Murray or somewhere, I want my lake to get down. But in the back end here, we have so much moss and goofy stuff that you cannot fish it on the bottom. You gotta hold it right here, but you gotta try to keep it up. You gotta keep it off the bottom. That's the crankbait I'm on. If I'm not fishing those right there right now, I'm fishing a flipper. Now, I know Mr. Robert Hale right here, this is his number one go-to anything. But I fish mine completely different than Matt. You heard him say a minute ago, he fishes a small hook and his flipper. I fish a five-off hook. And I run two-off trailer in it, and I hook it the way that most people never even thought of. So if y'all have to come up here and look at this, but I put trailer on the back of it. Just on this fish. And this, in another 6 weeks, that right there is what I saw. Now, Robert will tell you that the fluke is probably as good as anything you could probably have in your back. Because I know that he read it. But, you know, everybody has flukes in their tackle box, right? And what color are they? What color is most people? They're white. Alright. These are fixing going dead here real quick. I'm going to fix it white. I'm going to fix white. The water is not quite as clear. I'm going to fix it. This bubble gum will absolutely work real well. And if any of the provisions that get any stain to them at all, I put it in. not like they hit this foot right here. And I changed all the hooks. We looked at it, we got it done, so they all, I did it. One hits him, don't they? Because he looked at the chart. But what comes off it is, it's just, well, I changed every hook on almost every hook. Late in the afternoon, Robert? Lock tail with a little bit, I think. Love the front, but it's definitely. This time of year, I would throw the front. Get it on the thing, in, left, and afternoon, about the last of the week. Now, I do help, Matt and I are completely different because he's fishing his saltwater and I'm fishing freshwater. I help, I don't like gray line, freshwater, I fish gray line totally for saltwater, but I fish. This is called a nano line, it is a version of it, but it's not a spray boat. It's much rounder, it's, you throw it on. The only reason I do that is by using one of the flicks. And you see, I do have a reason. But I use a barrel filter here, so it keeps the fluid from flipping over and then turning, and you're trying to recruit them. Hot, sometimes they go up, they don't look like a real live. No, no, no. If you put that little filter like this, they normally stay frozen. Now, anything that I fish, like this, I fish mono. This is 12 pounds, because I want to stretch. So when I set the hook, I don't want it like mono, I like to spray it. There's no slack at all. I want it to pull, and I want that feel in the mouth when I'm pulling the front. So I just, I say break the grip, and I just don't use it. No guy who puts it down, but I'm glad. I think the trick I learned that you use is you're taking those Texas green jerseys. I'll fish